According to a new report out earlier this week, the report was put out by the Urban Health Collaborative at the School of Public Health at Drexel University. Very long name there. Sorry, I kind of stumbled through. But anyway, this report from this university says that if 30 of the nation's largest states had not put lockdown stay-at-home orders in place when they did, the current death toll from the coronavirus could be as much as a 250,000 American lives larger. These stay-at-home orders put in place by these 30 largest cities in this country in the early days of the pandemic saved 250,000 lives and more than 1 million hospitalizations. But we already kind of know that, right? I mean, that's a given. That's kind of common knowledge at this point. You put the lockdown stay-at-home order in place, it helps contain things, you get fewer infections, your numbers start to go down as long as you put it in place fast enough, like these cities did. So why even talk about this? Why bother bringing this up when it is something we all already know? And the answer is simple. We have states right now, some states that actually never put stay-at-home orders in place. Other states who had them in place, but they're now reopening because they feel like that's what the public wants them to do because they've seen a couple protests on TV, not realizing these protests were put together by AstroTurf conservative organizations that are actually funded by big corporations. And only about 11% of the public thinks we should end the lockdowns. Only 11%. Majority of Republicans, majority of Democrats, majority of independents all think these stay-at-home orders need to be kept in place for now. Medical experts say they need to be kept in place. Economic experts say they need to be put in place. But some states either haven't put them in place or they've already lifted them. Why? Because of partisan politics. And I know that sounds weird coming from me, hugely partisan, right? Huge dislike and distrust of the Republicans right here. Not as much, but still a large degree of distrust for the Democratic Party as well. But because we're so divided as a country, it's always left versus right, me versus you, I'm smart, you're dumb. Because of that, we have such wildly different responses state to state to state. And because of that, we're not flattening the curve yet. I mean, every other country that went through this, they managed to flatten it. Likely because they didn't have 50 different territories within their country, all run by different people with different political agendas, trying to score political points with a voting base here, voting base there. They didn't have to contend with that. But hey, we're Americans. We do things differently, and different doesn't always mean better. And we got to get that through our thick American skulls right now. Different doesn't mean better. Just because everybody else is ruled differently, or maybe they have a different form of democratic socialism than what we have with our meager Social Security program, that doesn't mean that they're wrong and we're right. In fact, as we're starting to see now, it means exactly the opposite. We are hyper-partisan here in this country, and that is literally killing us right now. We are so terrified of the word socialism that it's literally killing us right now. We have so many unmitigated corporate interests influencing our politics that it's literally killing us right now. I fear this country has kind of hit a point where we can't come back. And I think this pandemic is proof. And I'm not saying because Trump is president. This has been going on for far too long. This is not the result of anything Trump did. It's not the result of anything Obama did. It's the result of everything that every president has done since the 1980s. Since 1980, actually. Everything since then, over the last 40 years, has led us to where we are today. Unfettered capitalism, unlimited corporate money, hyper-partisanship, warped and skewed media. Every single thing I'm mentioning right here, you can trace back to one president. Not individually, but each one of those things was a different president putting those in place, screwing us all over without even realizing it. But it's all led to where we are today. Can it be fixed? I don't know. I don't think so. But for the sake of this country, we better hope that it can.